we welcome you to the Inspire Awards. Honoring the most inspiring people, youth, businesses, and organizations in the LGBT community in the Greater Toronto Area. The Inspire Awards are presented by supported by GLAAD. Proudly sponsored by Accenture. Live your inspiring life today. Visit inspireawards.ca.
Bonjour, denimi magadok. Anike gije dishnikas, mank dodem. My name is EJ Quanemens. I'm a member of the Loon Clan. I originate from the Robson-Superior 1850 Treaty Territory. My First Nation is Whitesun, otherwise known as Wabidanga. However, I presently reside in the City of Toronto. My role today is to speak on the land acknowledgements with regard to what this means and how this relates to each of us. Before I do that, I would like to acknowledge the Inspire Awards 2021 for bringing this virtual event before each and every one of you at this time. So thank you. Land acknowledgement in its meaning is typically a conversation or a statement that is oftentimes viewed or expected by settlers to acknowledge the land of which they are residing on out of respect and courtesy for the traditional people that call this area home. There are a number of land acknowledgements that exist, many of which acknowledge the Mississaugas of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, as well as the Wendat people. Traditionally, Indigenous people, when we used to travel to neighboring nations or territory that was not considered to be our traditional territory, we oftentimes would bear gifts and present these gifts to the people of which we were entering in their territory. So what does this mean to you? As a resident of Toronto or in the neighboring areas, it requires us all to have a responsibility to be mindful of how we interact with one another, how we interact and our views and how we function daily. It's important that we understand our roles and responsibilities as we are in a territory that may not be Indigenous to your people. Everyone here comes from somewhere, and it's important that we acknowledge the diversity that exists within each of us. But it also requires us to be mindful of the traditional territory of which the great city of Toronto is situated on and its original peoples that call this home. You gotcha.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jeffery Straker. I'm a singer, songwriter, and pianist, and I am delighted to be invited to sing a song to kick off this year's 2021 Inspire Awards. Of course, this is an evening to recognize and honor all things inspiring from across the LGBTQ landscape. And how amazing is it that we get an entire night to celebrate queer inspiration? It warms my gay heart. So thank you very much, Inspire Awards. And in fact, this is the 10th year of these awards. So congratulations, Inspire Awards, on your 10th anniversary. Here's to many more. A big hats off to all the nominees and recipients tonight. And of course, that includes our international icon of the year, the trailblazing, banjo-picking, singing like no other, Katie Lang. Thanks to each and every one of you for inspiring each and every one of us. Here's a song to get the night going.
Somewhere over the rainbow, we abide. There's a land that I heard of once. wish upon a star, to wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Oh, where troubles melt like lemon drops, way above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly.
Please welcome our host of the 10th anniversary of the Inspire Awards, the very funny and much love, Martha Chaves and Gavin Crawford.
Hey,
Gavin. Martha, hello everybody. What? We're wearing the same mask. How embarrassing.
Yeah, yeah. It's working 9 to 5, but it's working 5 to 9. Yeah, I should have called you. How you doing, Gavin?
There's no place like home, Martha, and that's where we're hosting
from
tonight.
There's no place like home.
Welcome,
it's
everybody.
It's great to be here in KB Lang's night, being that she's from your country, Alberta. She's your compatriot.
That's true. She is also your compatriot from Lesbos.
Yeah, well, that's true. And, but tell everybody here how you've been. How is the pandemia treating you? I hear that you're going around the city with your cat on a leash and you're 50 years old and you're around there and all
that. Well, thanks for that. Yes, that's how the pandemic's been for me. I'm now an eccentric 50-year-old gay man who walks my cats on a leash. So I'm just Quentin Crisp with a mustache over here. What about you? How have you been?
Well, I've been learning the Zoom, growing my hair, then hoarding face masks. You know, same old, same old. And I got the vaccine. And that's why we can be broadcasting today, because with the microchip I was implanted with the vaccine, I am the antenna. You know, it's amazing. And I want you all to go and get
Martha,
a vaccine.
This is no time for jokes, Martha.
Well, yeah, right. We're in the middle of the third wave. Everybody's stuck at home. But seriously, get vaccinated. Why do you think that the government will spy on you?
I mean, literally, Martha, there is literally no time for jokes. We have an amazing show and there's a lot of it. We've got awards to give out. We've got amazing performances coming up. We have inspiring messages from a whole host of amazing guests. So we should probably, get to it.
Yeah, that is right. It's the 10th anniversary of the Inspire Awards, as we said. And it's KD Lang's night. We have a lot of show for you. 10 years of celebration of LGBTQ plus folks.
That's right. Tonight, it's not only a show, it's a TED Talk, it's a Pride Parade, and a marathon, all rolled into one.
But we are here to make sure tonight goes as smoothly as Ontario vaccines rollout.
Okay, well, that's a pretty low bar.
Oh, well, but without further ado, like they say, let's the games begin. Please welcome the Minister of Diversity, Inclusion and Youth, the Honourable Bardish Chagger.
Thank you so much, Martha. Hello, everyone. Bonjour à tous. I would like to start by acknowledging that I'm joining you from Morlaix, Ontario, the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee, Anishinaabeg, and Neutral peoples. Congratulations to all the deserving recipients of this year's Inspire Awards. I am so pleased to be with you at this ceremony, albeit virtually. Celebrating and recognizing community leaders and change makers is always important, and it's especially important right now. This kind of recognition strengthens community bonds, and it brings us all together to celebrate positivity and find new inspiration to keep moving forward together. The Inspire Awards have been recognizing and honoring the achievements of LGBTQ2 trailblazers, including youth, businesses, and organizations in LGBTQ2 communities throughout the GTA for over 10 years now. That's quite a milestone. And I want to thank all the organizers, individuals, and community leaders who have supported and continue to support these awards. Since 2011, almost 300 awards have been presented to recipients who are leading by example. And this year's winners certainly fit that bill. They inspire us all through their commitment to equity, inclusion, and their determination to be fully and freely who they are. I know that you will be presenting Katie Lang with this year's International Icon of the Year. And she is a perfect example of what Inspire Awards are all about. She is indeed an icon, and we in Canada are glad to have her representing us. She is a champion for LGBTQ2 rights, a national treasure, and a true inspiration. Her example and the examples highlighted by all the nominees tonight help keep us all pushing towards a more equitable future. Whether it is promoting health education and awareness campaigns to underserved neighborhoods, ensuring intersectional representation in organizations, or being an inclusive role model for others to look to, each nominee tonight has contributed to a better Canada. I want you to know that under the leadership of Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, our government is fully committed to building an even better and consciously inclusive Canada, where everyone is free to be their true, authentic selves. Je veux que vous sachiez que sous la direction du Premier ministre Justin Trudeau, notre gouvernement s'est engagé à bâtir un Canada encore meilleur et consciemment plus inclusif, où chacun est libre d'être soi-même authentique. We're moving ahead with Canada's first ever federal LGBTQ2 action plan, and I'm pleased to say that over 27,000 Canadians have already engaged with us and offered their advice and perspectives on how the federal government can build equity and better serve LGBTQ2 communities from coast to coast to coast. And we've kept that commitment strong throughout Budget 2021, with funding to support the continued work of the LGBTQ2 Secretariat and Action Plan, and funding for initiatives to help LGBTQ2 communities overcome barriers in accessing health services or employment. I also know that you have excellent local champions that support this important work, like Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Rob Oliphant, as well as the MP for Toronto Centre, Marcy Ian, just to name a couple. We are taking these important steps to secure a future that we believe in, one where everyone is free to be who they are, to love who they love, and to lead truthful and authentic lives. I know that we can build that future together, and I know that you will be leading the way as you have been already, bringing hope and inspiration to us all just by being who you are. So congratulations once again to all this year's Inspire Award nominees and recipients. And thank you to all involved in putting this virtual event together. Your efforts are both noticed and appreciated. I hope you all enjoy this special night. Keep well and safe. Thank you. Merci.
Thank you, Minister. And now, please welcome Inspire Awards founder and president, Antoine Elhashem, to deliver the annual remarks on behalf of the...
Greetings from myself and on behalf of the Board of Directors of the Inspire Awards. On a normal year, I would be delivering this to you on stage at Hart House, University of Toronto. But this has not been a normal year and a half. How would we have loved to celebrate with you in person, see your smiling faces, give you lots of hugs. If you remember in the past, we said actually on stage at one of those opening remarks, how much we love giving hugs at the Inspire Awards. And of course, we would have loved to celebrate our 10th anniversary with you in person. But instead, we bring you the next best thing. And the next best thing is actually turned out to be spectacular. What a great evening has come together that you would not want to miss any part of it. So keep watching. Hope you're all settled in and ready for some inspiring moments, beautiful honorees, fantastic performances, and much, much, much more. Our community in any given time is resilient and rises to the challenges and struggles. That's one thing I admire very much about our community. Our struggles this year, however, are universal. So together we stand with the world, and we will be back celebrating in person, building back anything that didn't survive, and dancing together. To our honorees, you truly inspire us. Your work, your dedication, your courage, your advocacy, your contributions are all things that we celebrate. Thank you. It takes 9 intensive months of planning and work from our team of volunteers to put the Inspire Awards together and make it happen every year. And it's because we believe in you and all your work that it all becomes a joy and inspiration to us personally to celebrate you. I'll tell you one of the things we value most at the awards is the period when we have the nominations out and then we receive all those fantastic stories about people that you want us to celebrate, and we sit around tables and we read all those stories. And I kid you not, I have seen many, many teary-eyed eyes around the table over the 10 years, because your stories move us. When you inspire us, we feel it. And this is why 10 years ago, out of a very simple idea that celebrating and applauding good work and people benefits everyone, it feels good to be thankful. It feels good to be thanked. And to all of us who get together annually to celebrate them, it also feels really good to say thank you to them. A few calls were made and lovely people and community organizations came together 10 years ago to make the Inspire Awards happen and start. The first couple of years we celebrated at Casa Loma before moving the event to Hart House. I always say the reason why we are still here is because an honoree at the first event cried in my arms when we hugged, and we all who were there witnessed it, and we all knew how powerful it is to celebrate our community. I want to say, I can't believe we are still here 10 years later, but community, we all knew that we wanted to keep coming together in love and celebration because nothing feels like it. So I do believe that we are here 10 years later because it is important to be grateful to people who do good work. Let's get on with this amazing evening waiting for us. I'm going to lounge back on my couch in this tux and enjoy every moment of it. One of the things you will notice this evening on the broadcast is that performances and community messages are coming to us from so many different spots, including Canada and the rest of Canada and USA, which I personally find very beautiful to see how we can come together, especially in these challenging times. We still are close and connected. Our community is together no matter the distance apart. And I'm also thankful for the magic of virtual events because we can bring you this evening. Enjoy, happy 10th anniversary, and congratulations, community and honorees. One love, Inspire love. Thank you. Take care.
Hey, give it up for Antoine. He looks so dapper and elegant. not like us, that we are sitting down when my job is standing up, but I'm sitting down and I am in my shorts and flip-flops. But anyway,
it's been a long journey, Martha, from Casa Loma to Casa Martha.
Exactly. But we are having a lot of fun. And now we are thrilled to have Toronto City Councillor and a huge supporter of the Inspire Awards, the wonderful Kristyn Wong-Tam.
Hi, friends. This is Kristyn Wong-Tam, Toronto City Councillor. It's really great to be here with you to celebrate the 10th anniversary of the Inspire Awards. It's hard to imagine that 10 years ago, a group of individuals decided that we need to amplify and celebrate the successes in our community, in the LGBTQ2S community. And we needed to tell stories, and we need to mark our progress as we advance as a community, as a society. And I want to thank those founders, volunteers, board members at the Inspire Awards for bringing us together each and every single year. The Inspire Awards, generally attended by 400 people annually, to mark the occasion. Now, it has been remarkable watching the growth of the Inspire Awards take off. And it's also been incredible to see heroes and sheroes locally, nationally, and internationally celebrated in Toronto. International icons such as Carole Pope, as well as Stuart Milk, the nephew of Harvey Milk. The parents of Matthew Shepard, God bless them, and so many others who have given to the community and our movement. I know it's been a very difficult time. That pandemic has changed everything that we do, but I've also seen our community rise and be resilient. Our community is strong, and I'm sure that more heroes and sheroes have demonstrated their worth by just being who they are day in and day out, helping neighbors, helping their communities, helping their cities and towns. I'm so proud of every single one of you. I'm also very proud to know that over 300 recipients of the Inspire Awards has passed through the doors, let's just say virtually this year. And I'm very pleased to know that this organization will continue to march forward doing what it has done over the last 10 years. We've celebrated a lot of remarkable people and their incredible achievements. And I'll look forward to what the next 10 years will hold, not just for the Inspire Awards, but for the international LGBT community. I know that we have a great distance to go, but I'm also very proud of the distance that we have traveled together. So please be well, keep safe, and I'll see you on the other side. All the very best.
Yay!
Hooray, thank you, Councillor Wong-Tam. I feel like I'm an announcer on a parade route right now. Martha, if you just look around the corner, you can just see the first award is just turning the corner and heading down the block here. But before we start rolling out the awards and some really stunning performances, let's have the Inspire Awards and Nominations Procedures Committee tell us how it all works.
Yeah, because before the main course, you always have the appetizers. Before the main event, you get foreplay, you know?
Well, I mean, so, maybe you do. Tonight, we're just getting the rules. So here with those, please welcome Anna Goodmanis and Pauline Blackwood.
Here's how we do what we do. At Inspire Awards, we celebrate everyone who graces our stage, or virtual stage, as is the case this year. So we really don't use the word winners anywhere in our work. We have nominees, we have recipients, and that's it. Everyone wins when people work hard, volunteer time, and live authentically. Tonight, we celebrate all the great work done by everyone who will be on this broadcast. Inspire Awards receives nominations from the public through forms available on our website. The Lifetime Achievement Awards, the International Icon Award, and the Charles Roy Award for Activism in HIV/AIDS were voted on under the supervision of our Nominations and Procedures Committee at an early date.
For the other categories, Person, Youth, Business, and Community Organization of the Year, they are voted on by a jury panel made up of award board of directors, representatives of the community partners of the awards, and members at large of our LGBTQ plus community who are selected at random, or you can apply online to be a jury member. Earlier this week, this jury panel met together virtually and voted with a secret ballot under the supervision of our Nominations and Procedures Committee. The results are tallied by only Anna and myself, and the names of the recipients were locked up until this evening.
So let the celebration begin.
And that's how it all comes together. Before we hand out the first awards, though, get ready for a fusion of Hollywood golden era icons and pop vixens of the 21st century. One of the top three on season one of Canada's Drag Race. One of my favorite queens. Welcome, Scarlett BoBo.
Sweat, blood, money, sex. Twerk it till the money drops. Sweat, blood, money, sex. Twerk it till the money drops.
This is the way we applaud here, because you can hear, so you just go like this.
I dropped my money.
You dropped the money? Let's go. All of our past and present nominees have amazing bios. And if you want to know more about them, you go to inspireawards.ca.
Inspireawards.ca. Now, Martha, it is time to start with our very first category of the night, Inspiring Community Organization of the Year. Let's welcome the honorees nominated in this category. They are Here they are, a rainbow crosswalk for Bowmanville. Three Bowmanville sisters successfully lobbied for Durham Region's first rainbow crosswalk in Clarington.
Dorothy's Place, a safe space where participants can be themselves and form important personal connections.
Inside Out, Canada's largest LGBTQ plus film festival.
Maggie's, one of Canada's oldest bi and for sex worker support organizations.
And the Toronto Bisexual Network, a grassroots organization that advocates for, supports, and fosters community for bi plus people. All the nominees have been delivered their certificates to thank them for all their work and contributions. Thank you, honorees. Along with that, the recipient in person, youth, business, and community organizations categories will receive this fabulous trophy. If you're not familiar with the Inspire Awards trophy, they represent a flame, the flame that burns in our hearts as a community and our allies to be the best that we can be, and the flame that burns in me to get back into the dance floor of a gay bar one day. A flame. This is the trophy, and it will be going to the recipient.
You are my flame, Gavin. You are this flame. You are my inspiration.
I've been called a flame before, Martha, but not by you. All right. Okay. Martha, take it away.
Okay. And the envelope, please, although there is no envelope, it's only in my hair. And the recipient of Inspire Community Organization of the Year, drum roll, is Dorothy's Place.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much. Can I say a couple of words?
Sure.
Yes.
You have to.
On behalf of all of us at Dorothy's Place, thank you very much. Being recognized at this level for our work means a lot to us. Thanks to everyone who have made Dorothy's Place what it is today. Thank you to all of our supporters who dream with us of a better future. There are many S2LSBTQ older adults who need places where they can be themselves. We hope that we can inspire others to create spaces like ours. Our community needs more places like Dorothy's Place. Thank you.
Yay. Yeah. Well,
all right. You know, thank Gavin, you and congratulations.
That was so much fun, Gavin. I love handing out awards. And I hand an award from my heart to all of you. All of you.
Let's do some more handing out of awards. But before we do, as Kermit the Frog would say, let's check out a message from someone that's basically Canadian gay royalty.
Hi, everyone. Good evening and congratulations to the 10th anniversary of the Inspire Awards. I was an award recipient in 2015 and really happy to be here tonight to say a few words. So first of all, it's kind of fun. It's like a 50-50 draw tonight. We know some of the award winners, but there's lots of nominees. So first of all, a shout out to all the nominees. We need people that are really making a difference out there in the world right now and leading our community. So thank you for all that you do. Congratulations to Katie, to Natisha and Al Farouk, to Adam and Trevor. We know that you're going to get awards tonight. And I miss events like this so much. When I won my award in 2015, it was at the University of Toronto campus, beautiful downtown. And I just love hanging out, you know. And tonight at an event like this, I would probably see Carole Pope, who I've met before. I'd meet Bif for the first time. But what I'd really love is to see what people are wearing, the whole thing, not just from the waist up. So I would have been wearing these shoes if we could have been together. I'd love to see all your outfits. Have a fabulous night. And congratulations again, all the award winners and to 10 years of Inspire Awards.
Anyway, thank you, Mark Tewksbury. I practice a lot to pronounce that name, and I still don't know if I say Tewksbury. And if Mark was the princess, get ready for the queen of Canadian comedy. I'm not talking about moi, but seriously, we have Canadian gay royalty here. Give it up for the fabulous Rick Mercer.
Hi, I'm Rick Mercer. I'm in lockdown Ontario, which is just north of the town of Stay the Hell Home out of it.
also known as Toronto. Congratulations to all the honorees tonight. You know, I can't think of an award show with a better name because Inspire is what all of you do every single day. We have come so far as a community. You know, when I was a kid, the only LGBTQ organization I was aware of was Larry, Gus, Benita, Tonya, and Quentin. They were a gang of older kids who sat at the back of the bus and scared the hell out of us. You know, in hindsight, I think Quentin was queer. If so, I hope he's watching. Once again, congratulations. Have a fantastic night.
Thank you, Rick. All right, it is time to get to our very next award. Shall we, Martha?
Yes, let's welcome those being honored for LGBTQ plus Positive Business of the Year.
And I should say just congratulations on just staying in business this year. That's an achievement in itself. My goodness.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, nominated in this category are Come As You Are. Come As You Are is a queer and trans-owned sex-positive sex shop in Kensington Market, Toronto.
East King Productions. East King Productions is a trans and queer-owned and operated production company that was created to provide a safer, inclusive space for drag queens, drag kings, and gender performers.
Single and Eligible. Single and Eligible is Canada's most sophisticated speed dating and matchmaking company.
And Solo Theater. Creator of Solo Theater, Drag Heels, and She's the Man, Tracy unlocks stories that changed lives. And the envelope, please. The recipient of LGBTQ plus Positive Business of the Year is East King Productions. Hooray, congratulations.
Hooray. We should be telling jokes to Gavin to fill in these little.
Oh my God, that's so exciting. Oh.
There we go. Yeah.
Thank you so much. I'm not sure. Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, what to say? thank you to everybody. I appreciate it. Yeah. So sorry, my phone is lagging. Thank you so much. It's really exciting. I really actually would like to dedicate this award to a friend of mine who recently passed away. He actually helped me pave the way for East King Productions and made our events possible. I would like to dedicate it to Glenn. He is a community treasure and he will forever be remembered. So thank you all so, so much. This is amazing.
Hey, give it up for East King Production. And now let's take a musical break. This is a Toronto-based pop R&B group with a mission to represent the underrepresented and a YouTube channel that gets 7 million monthly views. Please welcome rIVerse.
What is up, ladies and gentlemen and genders? We are rIVerse. My name is Diz.
I'm Khadija.
My name is Zach.
And I'm Monroe.
Thank you so much for having us at the 10th anniversary Inspire Awards. And though it's a little different this year, we're all in our respective homes, being safe, socially distancing, it is such an honor to be continuing on with this tradition with you all.
Congratulations to all the honorees and recipients at this year's awards. It is so inspiring to see the great work that's happening in our community.
Tonight, we will be performing our latest single, Baby Boo, off of our sophomore album, Poison Ivy. Enjoy!
Loving overnight till the daylight breaks free. Double up with the movie songs I write about you, baby.
My baby, my boo. My baby, my baby, my baby.
whip girl gone bad, Mr. Day, I'm so seductive. Yeah, you want, come on, man, watch me TikTok, pop, drop, lip lock. It's a girl crush concept in your dick. Hit you with a love shot, call me Billy the Kid. Turn off your Snapchat, boy, come and get your cookie. 21 and over shit, you ain't dealing with a rookie poster.
How's that, what you want me in?
Yes, that's right, Martha. I mean, it is the internet, so there's bound to be a few technical glitches, but I just want to give a shout out to the production staff for managing to get all the nominees here with us in real time for these categories. It's something to orchestrate, so thank you, nominees, for being here, and thanks to the production team for making that happen. Our next category is LGBT plus Youth of the Year. Inspire Awards has insisted on the first ever year to celebrate the youth in that. Okay, now that as I've shouted them out, they're playing this back in my ear. The Inspire Awards has insisted from the very first year ever to celebrate the youth. After all, as I said the other day, I believe the youth are our future.
That wasn't you, that was Whitney Houston.
Well, she was right, Martha. Nominated in this category are Dage Hamilton. Dage is a Toronto-based furniture maker and designer who empowers people through her craft.
Leon Tsay. Leo is a trans femme who began public speaking and organizing first in the fields of feminism, LGBTQ+, and youth empowerment.
Max Cameron Farron. Max is a queer, non-binary, mad, and multiply disabled theater artist and community arts facilitator.
Mina Gerges. Mina is a model and actor challenging traditional gender roles and advocating for body positivity.
And Ryan Tran. Ryan began volunteering at 16 with queer Asian youth and has been working in the LGBTQ+ sector ever since.
And the envelope, please, drum roll. The recipient of the LGBTQ+ Youth of the Year is Daesh Hamilton.
Yay.
How are you?
There's Daesh.
That is so amazing. I just want to dedicate this to all the queer women of color out there. Just wow. Everyone who has told me that I couldn't, has told them that they couldn't. Listen, I'm here to tell you that you can. So go out there and be great. Thank you.
Yay! Hey, you see, my aspiration is that next year I get nominated in this category. The youth, but I will have to make up. No, we can still make a pact and find a picture that we can hang in our attic. It can still happen. But anyway, thanks, your Martha. Next message comes from a woman who just stopped for a second fighting with dog 4 on our behalf in order to be here delivering this message. Let's hear from Ontario NDP leader, MPP Andrea Horwath.
On behalf of your official opposition, NDP, I'm honored to share my congratulations with the award recipients and everyone at the Inspire Awards. I'm especially thankful to the organizers, the volunteers, and staff who worked so hard to bring back the Inspire Awards this year. For a decade, the Inspire Awards have recognized and celebrated 2SLGBTQIA plus communities in our province and been one of the hottest tickets in town. Thank you all for your strong example, for fighting for a more just and inclusive world, and for the incredible work of this year's award nominees, especially during these trying times. New Democrats are proud to stand with 2SLGBTQIA plus communities today and every day as we build that better world together. Congratulations again to all of you, and have a tremendous night.
And now let's hear a little bit from MPP Dr. Jill Andrew, a past honoree of the Inspire Awards herself. That's right. If you get honored by the Inspire Awards, you become a doctor and an MPP. So congratulations, everyone. Take it away, Dr. Jill.
Hey, Inspire Awards team and community. It's Jill Andrew, MPP for Toronto St. Paul's and the proud recipient of the 2018 LGBT Person of the Year Inspire Award. I want to say thank you to the entire team for doing this. I know it's a tough time. Yet again, here we are connecting virtually. It has been difficult, but we are still standing. We are still here, and we will keep fighting to do so. We'll keep fighting to get through this together. So please enjoy this evening. Let us celebrate each other. Let us remember those who have passed. Let us also fight for those who are still living. And please let us make the commitment to do that together for as long as we have to. So enjoy the evening. Thank you, Inspire Awards, and congratulations to every recipient this evening.
That was Dr. Jill Andrew. You see, Gavin, when you get a doctorate when you are in the Inspire Awards twice. And is that what we had to say? I don't remember. There was something, but that covers
the cool politicians portion of the evening, I believe.
Yes.
We're up to the next category, Martha.
Oh, yeah. The next category is the LGBTQ plus person of the year. The nominated are...
Chris Starch. Chris is the co-chair for Toronto People with AIDS Foundation, Friends for Life Bike Rally 2020.
Courtney McFarland. Courtney is a Jamaican-born visual artist, curator, poet, and activist in Toronto Black LGBTQ plus communities.
Karim Laddock, with 4 decades of leadership and philanthropy, Karim is a lifeline to many LGBTQ plus organizations.
Mocha Dawkins. Mocha is the power of emulation of love, sisterhood, community, freedom, and dignity.
And Yasmin Persad. Yasmin is a trainer and research coordinator working with trans women and LGBTQ plus people of color. And I have the envelope. The recipient of LGBTQ plus person of the year is Karim Laddock.
Yay!
Hi, can you hear me?
We can.
Yes.
Oh, wow. This is so wonderful. I mean, you know, this. I'm like a little bit shocked and actually very honored. But seeing the event started off with a land acknowledgement, and then seeing people like Jeff Straker and Minister Bardish, as well as Antoine with his bow tie, and Kristyn Wong-Tam and Jill Andrews, like, wow, what a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful event. I want to thank the Inspire Awards team for creating this magnificent evening. And both of you hosts are fantastic. Anna and Pauline and Darren and Mike are all awesome. I want to end by saying thank you to all of the fellow nominees, the award winners, as well as the trophy winners, and to say keep continuing to fight the fight for justice, equity, and inclusion. We are also very proud of you. You are not just pillars in our community, but you are actually stars in the sky. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Karim. I will feature the trophy once again, because I forgot last time.
The flame.
Speaking of the flame, in 2019, our community lost our beloved transgender rights activist, Julie Berman. Berman fought to raise awareness of anti-trans violence and ran Toronto's Trans Day of Remembrance, in which she also spoke. Tragically, Julie died the victim of a hate crime.
Her murder shocked the LGBTQ plus community and everybody who knew her. She was hailed as a lovely person who was committed to the political issues facing our community in Canada. John Tory, the mayor of Toronto and Pride Toronto, released statements mourning her death. The community held a vigil to mourn her in February 2020.
Here to say a few words is Julie's friend, Davina Hayter.
You're all so beautiful. Can we look at the neighbor next to us and tell them that they're beautiful? We're all beautiful, and people who ridicule us, judge us, make life hard for us, could not walk 5 minutes in our shoes. We are strong. It takes so much courage. Things may be getting better. We're more visible, but we still have a long way to go. And I hope that I'm alive to see the day when we're not such an army.
Yeah. Wow, you know, that was at the vigil. I was there. This was before the Rona. This was in February, and I live just around it. It was so lovely and moving. This is what I love about the Inspire Awards. There is a lot of show to celebrate our people, but there are also moments of reflections. Thank you once again, and give it up for Davina Hayter. Thank
yes,
you, Davina.
Thank you, Davina. Well, let's continue with this theme of inspiration, Martha. Now we have an artist who garnered worldwide audience with a constant message of inclusivity and equality for all people. And they've been called by the Advocate magazine the LGBTQ daddy of country music. Here is Drake Jensen.
Hey everyone, I'm Drake Jensen, and it's great to be here for the 10th Inspire Awards. And I'd like to send out a huge congrats to all of the people that are receiving awards. And I just want to tell you a little bit of story about a long time ago when I was 14 years old. My friend bought me birthday tickets to go to the Savoy Theater in Glace Bay, Nova Scotia, where I'm from, to see an incredible new singer and her band called Katie Lang and the Reclines. I had never heard of Katie Lang at that time. It was way back when she first started, and I went to the show and was absolutely amazed by the performance. Little did I know that so many years later, we'd be here and congratulating Katie Lang on getting the International Icon Award. So Katie Lang, I don't know whether you remember or not, but I was the guy in the front of the stage with the poster, and you signed on the bottom of my poster, "To dance as human and to polka divine." Congratulations, Katie Lang. Nobody deserves this any more than you. And thank you so much for being an inspiration to all of us for so many years. All the best on the award. Night, everybody. Have a great time.
You wiped it dry.
I was confused. You cleared my mind. I sold my soul. You bought it back for me and held me up and gave me dignity. Somehow you needed me. You gave me strength to stand alone again, to face a world out on my own again. You put me high upon a
Drake Jensen, everybody. Cape Breton representing.
Yay. Well, I know that on Facebook, there must be some people that don't know a lot about the Inspire Awards. You may want to hear a little bit of history. They were born 10 years ago based on a simple idea of Antoine. Antoine had this idea. Why don't we celebrate people in the community and give them awards, you know? And then, because he said, it feels good when a community thanks and acknowledges people's work and contributions. That is a very simple idea. Antoine had it, and he presented it to several people and organizations, and they created a mission and an annual event. And here we are with glitches and everything in the middle of the plague, but here we are. So please give it up again for the Inspire Awards.
We came together in a beautiful 10 years ago, now we stand here today. Our celebration of love is a gift to one and all. We want to sing a community song. We'll show the
was standing proud and tall.
Dance to.
Yeah, we are dancing in our chair. But now it is time for the prestigious Charles Roy Award for Activism in HIV/AIDS. No. Yes.
Hold up. Before we do that, Martha, I would like to take a moment to check in with the Secretary of the Board of Directors, Darren Steele, for the first moments of gratitude.
Hi, I'm Darren Steele, Secretary of the Board for Inspire Awards, and I would like to express gratitude to all of our sponsors and supporters without whom we would not be able to create and deliver this event year after year. Now, Inspire Awards is presented by a number of community partners, and they are Pink Play Mags and the Pink Pages Directory, the AIDS Committee of Toronto, ACT, the Ontario Gay and Lesbian Chamber of Commerce, the OGLCC, the Black Coalition for AIDS Prevention, Black CAP, the Alliance for South Asian AIDS Prevention, ASAP, Dudley's Hardware Paint and Decor, Toronto Trans Alliance, and for the support of GLAAD. Now, as I've said, at Inspire Awards, we cannot do what we do without the help of our generous sponsors and supporters. We would like to thank our presenting sponsor, Accenture, for their generous and continued financial contribution and commitment to Inspire Awards. Thank you so much for being here and supporting us, especially for this 10th anniversary celebration. To our platinum sponsor, Acacia Art Projects, for their incredible work that they did printing and framing the nominee certificates. They look absolutely gorgeous. They also acted as our welcome center so that the nominees could go and pick up their swag bags and their frames. They were a pleasure to work with. And to our gold sponsors, Core Design, for their ongoing web support year after year. And to Campbell, Roy, and Eldridge, who provide liability insurance for Inspire Awards Corporation. And to this year's silver sponsor, thank you so much to Urbaneer.com and Stephen Fudge for their financial support. We must give thanks to ACE Awards, who have created the absolutely stunning trophies for our recipients, to Mike May of Mike's Music Machine, who has been producing our annual event year after year at Hart House at the University of Toronto, while this year he went above and beyond to make this event virtual and live streamed. Finally, we are grateful to Rogers Communications and Rogers TV for airing this event live across Ontario, live for the very first time on Rogers, and they're making it available on demand during Pride Month in June. Thank you, and I'll see you again shortly.
Yay, thank you. Thank you very much to Darren, and thank you, Gavin, for interrupting me on my glitch. You know what happened? I went to get a drink at my kitchen, and then I came back, and I was a little discombobulated. Can you imagine?
You skipped over the
Yes.
Of the sponsors, you would have single-handedly canceled the Inspire Awards forever.
Oh no, I'm sorry, everybody. It was a glitch.
Everything is, it's golden.
It's fine.
What time is it now, Martha?
It is time. It is time for the prestigious Charles Roy Award for Activism in HIV/AIDS.
The award was named after the late Charles M. Roy, who was the executive director of ACT and a personal friend and mentor of many. In his lifetime, Charles made significant contributions and advancements to the fight against HIV locally, nationally, and internationally.
Now we celebrate the addition of another much-deserving honoree to the list of recipients in this category.
And that honoree is Trevor Stratton, a two-spirited citizen of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation near Toronto, Canada, with mixed English and Ojibwe heritage. Diagnosed with HIV in 1990, Trevor is now the coordinator for the International Indigenous Working Group on HIV and AIDS for its host organization, the Canadian Aboriginal AIDS Network.
Congratulations to Trevor, and let's hear a few words from him.
And it looks Maori. It looks Indigenous, doesn't it? I just love it. It's beautiful, and I'm going to put it in a place where I can see it and I can show it off. I've lived, like you said, I lived 31 years with HIV, and let's face it, in the early days, we were desperate. Many of my friends died. But a lot of my HIV activism has been in the Indigenous HIV movement in Canada and around the world. I'm actually a citizen of the Mississaugas of the Credit River First Nation, as you mentioned. We share the territory with the Anishinaabe and the Haudenosaunee Confederacy. I've been so lucky to be mentored and guided from different leaders from the Canadian Aboriginal AIDS Network, Pauktuti, Inuit Women of Canada, the Ontario Aboriginal HIV/AIDS Strategy, Two-Spirited People of the First Nations, and the Ontario First Nations HIV/AIDS Education Circle. In particular, you may remember Laverne Monette and Art Sokol. And AIDS isn't over yet. We have to keep going, don't we? Yeah. We've made incredible gains, but there's still a lot of work to do, especially for marginalized populations like the African, Caribbean, Black communities, and Indigenous peoples. I'm so honored to receive the Charles Roy Award. Charles has been like an icon to me, one of the front runners advancing the notion of the greater involvement of people living with HIV, like me and like so many others. Activists like me, we stand on the shoulders of giants like Charles. I feel like my batteries have been recharged as we continue to like strive and struggle toward the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals and getting to zero by 2030. Zero AIDS-related deaths, zero new infections, and zero HIV discrimination. Thank you. Merci, Mi Guech and Nya Wen. Thanks so much.
Congratulations, Trevor, and thank you for all of your hard work. Martha, what a great night this is to be both inspired and to be entertained. In fact, your next act is Grammy-nominated and winner of Song of the Year at the Folk Alliance International Awards. Give it up for Amythyst Kiah.
Hey, everybody. My name is Amythyst Kiah, and welcome to my living room here in Johnson City, Tennessee. I am super excited to be able to contribute to this year's Inspire Awards. This is obviously being done virtually, and I hope in the future I can actually go to Canada and actually see you all in person. This has been a very trying and challenging year. There's been a lot of things we've all had to adapt to and adjust to. And, you know, if you're watching this, thanks for hanging in there. Thanks for continuing to support live music and for continuing to support LGBT artists and business owners and all of us out here trying to do our thing. So thanks so much again. And congratulations to everybody that's been nominated this year. I'm going to sing a song that is off of my upcoming record entitled Wary and Strange. And the song is called Wild Turkey. It's going to be, or is the second single off of that record. So I hope you enjoy. And again, thanks to Inspire Awards for asking me to be part of this and hopefully see you in person in the future.
Late at night when I feel alone, I cry in darkness, screaming to the unknown, 'cause she's never coming back. No, she's never coming back. Body in water for days and days, hopes for a safe return were hopes in vain, 'cause she's never coming back. No, she's never coming back. When I was 17, I pretended not to care. Stayed numb for years to escape despair. When your soul dies, you just can't hide it. Everyone can tell. Hold on, will I ever feel right again? Tried so hard to be an automaton, body of steel and wired circuits for my backbone, 'cause she's never coming back. No, she's never coming back. Wild turkey in the car seat, the bottle's empty, I hope it gave her some relief, 'cause she's never coming back. No, she's never coming back. When I was 17, I pretended not to care. Stayed numb for years to escape despair. Your soul dies, you just can't hide it. Everyone can tell. Oh Lord, will I ever feel? Pretended not to care. Stayed numb for years to escape despair. When your soul dies, you just can't hide.
wow, that was a wonderful. You know, if she doesn't come back, it's because she is not thinking straight. Because you are a wonderful amethyst. Wonderful, wonderful. I'm going to get your music. I am very clamped.
Amethyst Kiah, everybody. The next award honors an individual for their achievements within the science and technology sectors to promote diversity and inclusiveness and improve lives and raise awareness about LGBTQ plus issues. It's the Accenture LGBTQ plus Innovator of the Year Award.
Adam Zivo is the founder and director of Love is Love is Love, an LGBTQ plus advocacy campaign that has disseminated queer positive content to over 1 million people.
Adam champions institutional engagement, incremental change, and intercommunity diplomacy, driven by the belief that it is as important to raise the floor of minority rights as it is to raise the ceiling. But before we hear from Adam, here are a few words from award presenter Accenture.
Accenture's purpose is to deliver on the promise of technology and human ingenuity, and our commitment to our people, clients, and communities is to accelerate equality for all. That is why Accenture is proud to be the presenting partner of Inspire Awards for the second year in a row. We want to congratulate the awards on their 10th anniversary and to all of this year's nominees and recipients. And a big shout out to Katie Lang on being this year's International Icon recipient. And of course, we want to congratulate this year's recipient of the Accenture Innovator of the Year Award, Adam Zivo.
Am I on? Oh, sorry. I want to say thank you so much for presenting this award. It took a lot of work for this scholarship to happen, and a scholarship is something that is not made by just one person. So I want to also thank the partners who helped make that scholarship happen. I want to thank Peace Collective, the clothing brand based out of Toronto, for trusting Love is Love is Love and working with us to do a capsule collection that raised funds for our initial seed capital to build the initial stages of the scholarship. I want to thank Mongrel Media, which partnered up with us again to do a charitable film screening to bump up the amount of money that we could disperse to young LGBT STEM leaders. And I'd like to thank ScholarTree, which is an Ontario-based millennial-run scholarship program / tech startup, for administering the scholarship program for us, because evaluating hundreds of scholarships is something that is very difficult to do, and certainly we needed a partner for that. So something like this is made with a team, not just one person, so I want to take that opportunity to thank everyone who was involved. And I want to thank you, I want to thank the Inspire Awards for this recognition, and for supporting the community and activists more generally. So keep up the good work, and thank you once again. I'm incredibly grateful.
Congratulations, Adam Zivo, on becoming an Inspire Awards honoree. Antoine is right. It does feel good to thank the people in our community for the great work that they do.
Yeah. And now let's hear this next group. They are a lot of fun. They are from Toronto. They are grown as burly men, and they cover songs originated by girl groups. Here it is, MANifesto.
Hi. I'm Kelly.
Twain.
Icarus.
Brian.
Dionisio. And we are
MANifesto.
We are honored to be part of this year's Inspire Awards.
What a thrill to be on a platform with all the great Canadian lesbians of rock and roll.
Carole Pope, K.D. Lang,
Scarlett BoBo.
MANifesto are five grown-up gays from Toronto who cover songs originated by girl groups. Am I getting that right?
Yeah. Thus far, you've heard us perform Automatic by the Pointer Sisters. Automatic whenever you're around. I'm walking blindfold.
Promise from Girls Aloud.
You're gonna make me love you. Nothing at all, nothing that I do. Promise I made, starting to fade, starting to fade. You're gonna make me love you. Nothing at all, nothing that I do. Promise I made, promise I made.
I'm coming this June in time for Pride.
We'll be releasing a song made famous by a UK quintet that were somewhat famous in the 90s, right?
They did okay. What were they called again?
Nope. We're working hard this month to complete our debut album, which will be out in September.
No, really, what were they called?
Okay, we got that.
Who else do we have on this record?
The Cordettes.
Exposé.
La Belle.
Bananarama.
Fifth Harmony.
Old Saints.
En Vogue.
And this gem from 1964 by the Springs.
Our album version will be a little different from the original.
But just for the Inspire Awards, we thought we'd do something in the style of the Nylons, as they have inspired us so many times over the years.
Can't touch the gods. But we'll try.
Shall we give it a go?
Let's give it a go.
3, 4. I've been crying. Boo hoo. Cause I'm lonely. For you. Smiles have all turned to tears. But tears won't wash away the fear that you're never ever gonna return. To ease the fire that within me burns. It keeps me crying, baby, for you. Keeps me sighing, baby, for you. So won't you hurry, come on board. See about me, come see about me.
See about you, baby,
come see about me.
You know I'm so lonely,
come see about me.
I love you only,
come see about me.
See about you, baby,
come see about me.
Hurry, hurry,
come see about
me.
Congratulations to all the recipients of this year's Inspire Awards.
And thank you for all the joy that you bring into this world.
Follow us on all the anti-socials at Manifesto Times 5.
And we look forward to seeing you all in person. Very.
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 Very soon.
Much love.
All that I want from you is the promise you will be there.
Has been changed. The new number is...
You've been erased.
Please not...
I don't know. What is it the voices in my head? I have no idea. I just want to say, bravo, Manifesto. I'm going to steal your dresses. That's what I'm going to do. And I'm gonna download your music. Yes.
I want to take a minute to tell you a little bit about Q Experience.
No. You're not going to convince me to join QAnon.
No, Martha. Q Experience. It's very, very different. Q Experience initially started as a walk and monument of heroes. It's a community project championed by the Inspire Awards with the support of Toronto City Hall. All Inspire Awards Lifetime Achievement Award recipients will be inducted into Q Experience. That way, they will forever be remembered for their contributions and always acknowledged as a part of our history. Check it out. Martha, if you weren't already excited, you're about to get more excited because we are now getting into the Lifetime Achievement Awards, followed by International Icon. The honors in the following categories go to those who made significant contributions to improve the lives of others in the community over an entire career or a lifetime.
Our first honoree for Lifetime Achievement is Dr. Notisha Masakwai. Notisha is originally from Sierra Leone and has been an enthusiastic advocate for advancements in Black women's healthcare globally for more than 30 years. She's a founding staff member of Africans in Partnership Against AIDS and has served for 21 years as the executive director of Women's Health in Women's Hands Community Health Center in Toronto, Canada.
Most recently, Notisha co-chaired the Toronto Police Service Board's Anti-Racism Advisory Panel. Her personal passion to improve the conditions of LGBTQ plus communities globally has allowed her to work with grassroots organizations throughout Africa and the Caribbean for many years.
Congratulations, Dr. Notisha Masakwai. Let's hear a few words from you.
Congratulations.
I, of course, want to thank the Inspire Awards. I also want to congratulate all of the nominees, all of the winners from all of the categories. And I have to thank my beautiful family. You cannot achieve a lifetime of work without family and close friends supporting you. I also have to thank my fellow partner in solidarity, El Farouk, who will be also receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award. I have to say that I accept this award on behalf of all people globally and the many people who cannot be out, who cannot be who they want to be, and who cannot love who they want to love. So thank you so much, Inspire Awards. It's been a wonderful, wonderful honor and surprise and pleasure to be honored in this way. Thank you.
Congratulations. Hooray. Yay, doctor.
Our other honoree this year for lifetime achievement is El Farouk Kaki. El Farouk is a Tanzanian-born Shia of Canadian Indian origin who is a refugee and immigration lawyer and human rights activist on issues including gender equality, sexual orientation, and progressive Islam. In 1993, Kaki founded Salaam, the first gay Muslim support group in Canada and second in the world.
He has served on the Toronto Mayor's Committee on Community and Race Relations, on the board of the 519 Community Center, and he is now elected chair of Africans in Partnership Against AIDS. Congratulations, El Farouk Kaki. Let's hear a few words from you.
Hooray. Hi.
Don't worry, blame right, it on the Rona.
Okay. Hi, can you hear me now?
Oh, yay!
We can.
Yay. Okay, awesome. Hello, everybody. I'm El Farouk. I go by he pronouns, and I am here in Toronto, Tacoronto, in the traditional territories of the Mississaugas of the New Credit. I am really honored to be receiving this really awesome and really, really heavy award. I'm really chuffed that I'm receiving it by an organization, from an organization like the Inspire Awards, which is founded in among grassroots organizations and in activism. And my honor to share tonight with the likes of Karim Ladak and my sister Notisha Masakai. Notisha and I end up in similar spaces and similar places sort of at the same time. She was honored Dyke and I was Grand Marshal years ago. And so here we are again. I wore purple anticipating that she too was going to wear purple today, but that didn't happen because we often wear purple at the same time, usually of African design. I'm really honored to be receiving this. And I want to congratulate all the other nominees nominees and recipients. And I see the wrapping up finger. And so, thank you.
Thank you, Al Farouk.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. And to the people watching us at home, but you know, sometimes we get little glitches. You just have to forgive us because we are fantastic, right? Right, Gavin?
I agree. I concur. You concur? Are you excited about the next performer?
You cannot imagine how excited I am to bring up our next performer. I am thrilled. And all of the, how do you say, thesaurus. Thrilled, excited, you know. I never suspected that I was going to be introducing her. She reigns supreme as a gold and platinum selling artist, Juno Award winner, songwriter, author, and advocate. Please give it up for the one and only Bif Naked!
Hi, I'm Bif Naked, and this is Snake Allen, and this is Ace, and we're in the studio. And happy and honored to take this break so that we can say hello to everyone and congratulate Inspire Awards on 10 years of amazing, loving work in the LGBT community and beyond. We wanted to perform a song that really kind of symbolized how, I guess, I feel, not just as an artist, but as a person, and what I wanted to share with you, because I think that sometimes having positive affirmations really, really makes a difference in our lives. And I love myself today is the best thing you could probably say to yourself. I know for me anyway, it helped me get through a lot of times. So this is I love myself today. You left me like a broken doll in pieces as I took a fall. For you, you don't chomp, you let me free fall like space junk, burning up in the atmosphere of life. Well, that ain't right. I sound like a philosopher, but I'm a fool that's off a rocker. Cause I let you in my heart that one last time. I had enough, made up my mind. I'm gonna get up, out, wow! I love myself today, not like yesterday. I'm cool, I'm calm, I'm gonna be okay, I love myself today, not like yesterday. Take another look at me now, cause it's your last look, your last look forever. You, you're all puffed up in that big red truck, but you're out of luck this time. Yeah, that's tough. I'm on fire, too hot to touch, with a chat room full of lovers on the line. Go step right up, special muscle. I'm gonna be proud, loud, out of control. Love myself today, not like yesterday. I'm cool, I'm calm, I'm gonna be okay. Not like yesterday. Take another look at me now. This is your last look. Your last look forever. I'm looking in the mirror and I like what I see. I lost the fear and the horror that's been eating at me. Cause being with you was like a hangman's noose. I've been living my life in dead man's shoes. I had enough, made up my mind. I'm gonna get up, out, wow! I love myself today, not like yesterday. I'm cool, I'm calm, I'm gonna be okay. I love myself today, not like yesterday. Take another look at me now. Love myself today,
Not like yesterday, you're dead, gone, gonna get my way, love myself today. Not like yesterday, take another look at me now, cause it's your last look forever. Love myself today. Love myself today. Yay! Good girl. Yay!
The Inspire Awards over the years have celebrated with an honorary Lifetime Achievement Award individuals who have contributed significantly to the community but are no longer with us. This year, we celebrate two individuals.
George Hislop. He was one of the leading gay rights activists. He helped organize the first gay rights demonstrations on Parliament Hill in 1971.
During the notorious bathhouse raids of 1981, George was a leader in the successful resistance to that persecution. He also lobbied Parliament for the inclusion of gays and lesbians in the Charter of Rights and fought for the inclusion of sexual orientation in Ontario's Human Rights Code. In 2003, at the age of 76, he spearheaded a national class action for CPP same-sex survivors' pensions, which resulted in the largest class action trial judgment in Canadian legal history. George was the first openly gay person to be appointed to civic office in Canada. The city acknowledged his lifelong contribution by the creation of George Hislop Park in the heart of Toronto's lesbian and gay community. To accept on George Hislop's behalf is close friend and estate executor, Christopher Hudspeth.
I want to thank the Inspire Awards for this honorary Lifetime Achievement Award being given to George Hislop. George Hislop was a pioneer in our community, a leader in LGBTQ rights, a politician, a businessman. He did all kinds of wonderful things for our community and for the city of Toronto. I want to thank you again for this wonderful award and for inspiring great leaders and great leaders in our future.
The other recipient this year of this award is Ruth Ann Tucker. Ruth Ann dedicated her life to the HIV/AIDS communities, working at ACT, Five House, Ontario HIV Treatment Network, and the Hamilton AIDS Network.
Under Ruth Ann's leadership, Five House's housing outreach and community programs grew and flourished. She spearheaded the partnership with Wellesley Central Health Corporation and Woodgreen Community Services to develop a new supportive housing project for people living with HIV/AIDS and seniors. The Tony DiPietti Residence, Wellesley Central Residence, is the culmination of her incredible work and provides 112 units of supportive housing. In partnership with a network of community leaders in the HIV/AIDS sector and the Ontario HIV Treatment Network, Ruth Ann played a pivotal role in the development of the seminal piece of research, Positive Spaces, Healthy Places, the first of its kind in Canada. A plaque marking the Fife House rooftop as Ruth Ann Tucker Memorial Garden has been erected in her honor. To accept the honorary Lifetime Achievement on behalf of Ruth Ann Tucker is good friend Donna Braybrook.
Good evening, everyone. I'm very happy to be here this evening and honored to have been asked by Ruth Ann's partner, Lisa, to accept the 2020 Honorary Lifetime Achievement Award on behalf of Ruth Ann Tucker. Ruth Ann inspired many people. She was a big, proud, butch lesbian with a huge heart who left an impression on everyone she met. She knew how to get the job done. Her work made Toronto a better place for the LGBTQ community and specifically for people living with HIV and AIDS. I know that Ruth Ann would have also wanted to thank the team of people who worked with her to make her achievements possible, as well as obviously thanking Lisa for all her support through the years. On behalf of Ruth Ann, I thank you for this acknowledgement of her contribution to the LGBT community. And in her memory, I urge you to stand up, be proud, and continue to look for ways to inspire the LGBTQ community in whatever ways you can. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Donna. Recently, the local community in Toronto lost an iconic figure and an iconic performer on the drag stage. We wanted to take a minute to remember Earl Barrington Shaw's beautiful creation, Michelle Ross.
The wonderful Michelle Ross. And now let's check again with Secretary of the Board of Directors, Darren Steele, for the second of Moments of Gratitude.
Hey, it's Darren Steele here again for part two of Gratitude Messages from Secretary of the Board. There are many more people to thank. First of all, to EJ Quandibens for the Indigenous land acknowledgement that opened the event. For the opening remarks by the Honourable Bardish Chagger, Minister of Diversity, Inclusion and Youth, thank you so much for being with us this evening and for taking the time. To the ongoing continued support of this event, thank you so much to Toronto Councillor Kristyn Wong-Tam. To the amazing, incredible hosting abilities of Martha Chaves and Gavin Crawford, let's give them a round of applause. I won't clap right into the microphone. And to all of the evening's amazing performances, the thoughtful messages from our talented artists and entertainers, Carole Pope, Bif Naked, MANifesto, Scarlett BoBo, rIVerse, Amythyst Kiah, Drake Jensen, and Jeffery Straker. Thank you so much for making our event so absolutely wonderful and entertaining. To Anna Gutmanis, who's chair of the Nominations and Procedures Committee at Inspire Awards, an incredibly talented singer-songwriter who wrote and performed the original song for our 10th anniversary, Inspire. Thank you to the members of the jury, both from our community of partners and members of the community at large who met to cast their votes for the nominees this past Monday evening. A very big shout out to all of the companies who made donations to fill the gorgeous swag bags that went to all of our nominees. And they are, in no particular order, Cole Yanni Card Company for their very cute, quirky, and queer greeting cards and decals. To Peace by Chocolate from the East Coast, who donated their delicious rainbow chocolate hazelnut bars. To Georgian Bay Spirits Company for their six-pack of smashed tea, their cocktail recipe booklet, and they also allowed us to use their gorgeous carry bag so we could put all the swag in one easy-to-carry place. To Hophead, School of Jam, Hazy IPA, enjoyed loudly, as they like to say. And finally, the Spice Trader for their rose, sugar, and Himalayan sea salt samples. That is quite the swag bag. Finally, we would like to thank Silverthorn Studios for helping us to produce the original song for our 10th anniversary, and to North Bay Pride for their sponsorship of Bif Naked's performance. Thank you so much, and enjoy the rest of the awards.
All right. Thanks very much, Darren Chatua. No, it's Darren Steele. This is me, Gotham. Coming soon, the final big award for the evening, the International Icon Award. That's right. We are almost there, everyone. But first, let's check out this video message from Sarah Kate Ellis, president of GLAAD.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Sarah Kate Ellis, the president and CEO of GLAAD. Congratulations to all the nominees and award recipients tonight. As a past recipient of the International Icon Award, I want to give a huge congratulations to my idol, Katie Lang, on this award. Your visibility has helped countless people and created real change in music and culture overall. And finally, a big congratulations to the Inspire Awards on this huge accomplishment. 10 years of honoring the LGBTQ community in Toronto. Thank you. You inspire us every day.
Yes, I'm
Are you excited, Martha?
I am like besides myself. You cannot imagine. If I can tell you confidential, this is, you know, my heart is pounding because performing at the 10th anniversary Inspire Awards is none other than the legendary agent provocateur, badass extraordinaire, multiple awards recipient, the one and only, the indomitable Carole Pope.
Hey, as a past international icon recipient of the Inspire Award, I would love to congratulate Katie Lang. You rock. You're just beyond the beyond. And also congratulate all the other honorees and recipients. And happy 10th anniversary, Inspire Awards. And everybody, just be safe and be strong. I love you.
Let's go into the forest and menstruate on a stick. Look, there's a drum circle. Maybe we could join in. Let's go down to the fire pit and roast some tofu dogs. Maybe some ducks in a tent. We'll have some beer. Oh, yeah. To fist fuck, we can do whatever we want, cause this is a man-free zone, except for the guys who empty the chains. We don't call them Johns. Here at the Michigan Women's Festival, we worship the goddess. We're lesbians in the forest. Frightening body walk around naked. Why do women grow facial hair? Why do I have to look at that? No offense to anyone who's transitioning. Ah, fuck! There's my ex with her new girlfriend. But you are so much hotter. You're Ellen's ex, Katie's ex, Alicia's ex.
This is a forest, same-sex schmorgas, fuck a Greek chorus. I swore this would be a dinosaur weekend. Dyke beacon, hair Mohican. I diddle a woodland fairy, whittle my woody scary. Middle of me is hairy, middle of me is dairy. Nymphs, fairies, witches, not a cock in sight. Cause sisters are doing themselves all night.
Yeah, lesbians in the forest.
Thank you.
Carole Pope.
Gavin. And now we arrive at the moment you have all been waiting for, the celebration of this year's International Icon.
For those of you who don't know, the three people here that don't know who our honoree is, she's a singer, songwriter, an actress, and a fearless advocate for the LGBTQ+. She's also a passionate animal rights activist. KD, in 1990, she fronted Meat Stinks, a campaign organized by PETA, which got her banned in more than 30 radio stations in Carnivore, Alberta, and probably at my relative's house because they eat meat. But
she has won 8 Judos, 4 Grammys, a Brit, an AMA, a VMA, and 4 awards from GLAAD. In 1996, she received the Order of Canada, and in 2013, she was inducted into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame. In 2020, she received the Alberta Order of Excellence. Alberta gets there eventually. And this evening, we celebrate the icon, the legend, the much beloved Canada's own Katie Lang.
But before we hear from KD, we have a surprise to both KD and all of you watching, and even you, Gavin. You don't know who it is. I don't even know. But check out our very special guest.
And the honors just keep pouring in. Congratulations, KD, on this latest feather in your cap. I know you'll wear it well. Sending love and best wishes, as always.
Wow, and more, Carole Pope, KD Lang. You know, people that I'm not in my remote imagination, I never thought I would be in a show with them. And now they're going to be on my resume, Gavin. Thanks, the pandemic.
One positive thing, thanks to COVID for you, Martha. There you go.
Yes, thanks, my heart COVID, is pounding.
For padding out Martha Chavez's resume. Katie Lang, for your talent, your advocacy, and humanity, and on behalf of the Inspire Awards, Toronto's local community, and everyone who has enjoyed you over the years, near and far, we are absolutely thrilled to present you with the International Icon Award.
Hey there, it's Katie Lang. I'd like to thank the Toronto community, the Inspire Awards organization, for all that you do, and I'm just so deeply honored that you are acknowledging my small contribution. I'd also like to thank one of my biggest idols, the one and only, the great, the sexy, and the extremely supportive Anne Murray. Thank you, Anne, for always being there for all of us. And thank you so much. Oh, and happy 10th anniversary. That's amazing. Go team, go.
Yay!
Hooray, congratulations. Well, thank you, congratulations. Katie Lang.
Yeah.
We have done it, Martha Chavez. We have reached just about the very end of the 10th annual Inspire Awards. Thank you to everyone who participated tonight, to all of the amazing performers and people who sent in messages. Congratulations to all of the honorees and all of the nominees, and to the team who put this year's virtual Inspire Awards together.
Thank you, Mike.
All right, I'll see you soon, Martha. We'll leave you now with a message from that very Inspire Awards team. I'm Gavin Crawford. Good night,
everybody. Thank
you, everybody.
And I'm Martha Chavez.
Welcome back, everyone. You met some of the team that you see their beautiful faces on the screen during the broadcast, but we want to take a moment to introduce ourselves properly to you. Let's start with Carrie.
Hi, everyone. My name is Carrie Johnston, and I am the Vice President of the Board of the Inspire Awards. And I want to congratulate all of our nominees and all of our recipients of awards this evening. And also, I would like to thank all of you for tuning in and joining us for this great 10th anniversary celebration.
Thank you, Carrie. Darren.
Hi, everyone. I'm Darren Steele, Secretary of the Board, and I've done a couple of moments of gratitude tonight. So I just want to mention thank you to the team and for all the work that's gone into putting this together, the moments of enjoyment and just the feedback between the start of this nominations and then vetting and then preparing and then bringing in artists and listening to the feedback from different people that you speak with throughout the year and how grateful they are to be nominated. That's what's really inspiring for this. And congratulations on 10 years, Inspire Awards. And one more time, congratulations to all the honorees, all the recipients, and our international icon, Katie Lang.
Thank you. Lucy.
Hi, everybody. My name is Lucy Gialla, and I am part of the board, board member from the Inspire Awards since 2019. What a fabulous event we just had, and happy 10th anniversary. Congratulations to all of our honorees and nominees from this year and all the years past. Thank you, Antoine, for celebrating and inspiring our community. You are an inspiration, an amazing being. Please join us, share the journey of honoring our community and submit your nominations for 2022. We will have another great event. And cheers to us, cheers to more magic, more laughter, more positive light to our community, for our allies and the world in general. Thank you.
Thank you. And thanks for your kind words, very humbling. Anna.
Hey, I'm Anna Gutmanis and I'm the chair of nominations and procedures. Wow, what a show we've just had. What a group that we've been working with to put everything together. As a musician, I just have to do a shout out to all the musical acts because they were amazing. And of course, the finale of the show, Katie Lang, it just doesn't get any better than that. Thanks to Gavin and Martha. Thanks to everybody in the community who's ever done any work for LGBTQ rights. And let's remember how far we've come and how far we still have to go. And I'm with Lucy. Yeah, please join us for the next time around.
Beautiful. Pauline.
Hi, I'm Pauline Blackwood, and I was on the Nominations and Procedure Committee with Anna, and it's my first year doing the Inspire Awards, and I've just been blown away with the work of the team, and I want to congratulate all the nominees and recipients for tonight. And I'm so excited to be celebrating the 10th anniversary.
Thank you. We do have a guest with us tonight. Last but not least is Joey Lamar, a past vice president of the Inspire Awards and the current chair of the Q Experience that you guys heard about during the broadcast. Joey.
Hi, I'm Joey Lamar. And as Antoine said, I've spent 4 years as part of the board and vice president. And now I have the honor of continuing on as part of the Q Experience. I want to congratulate not only this board, but all of the board of directors for the past 10 years, the nominees, the honorees, the recipients. It's certainly been a highlight of my life during my tenure with the board of directors. Antoine, as Lucy mentioned, you're an amazing person. Your vision continues on. I'm so proud that we're here celebrating 10 years. I remember sitting with you at 3 years talking about this, right? Thank you for all you all do, beautiful people. Let's keep it going. Love to all. Thank you.
Again, very humbling. And just to remind us all that it takes a village. These are just some of the beautiful people that have passed the Inspire Awards over 10 years. There's been a lot of amazing teams. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. If I don't tell you every day how much I love you and I love your contributions, and we became friends. We're all an extended family over the last 10 years, and you have filled my personal life with a lot of wonderful memories, and it's been an honor to celebrate so many amazing individuals, businesses, youth organizations in our community over the last 10 years. And with that, we bid you goodbye.
Thank you for joining the Inspire Awards for 2021. We'd like to thank all our sponsors, partners, and proud supporters for making this year so special. We hope that you'll stay safe, and we'll see you next year. Don't forget to check out inspireawards.ca.